أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. وعباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. فالحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم. قرآن ويكلي. Allah Azza wa Jalla, at the end of Surah Al-Furqan, Surah number 25, has a passage describing those who are the slaves of Ar-Rahman. Allah has many names, and He can attribute, call people slaves of Allah, slaves of the Creator, slaves of the wise. But when He calls them slaves of Ar-Rahman, it is as though He is suggesting that these people have a relationship with Him based on His endless and unimaginable love and mercy and care. So the slaves of the one who cares a lot, the slaves of the one who loves a lot, the slaves of the one who shows mercy unimaginably. So that means that these are special people. That the people Allah is describing at the end of this passage are very, very special people. All believers are special, but these are extra, super, duper, awesome, special. Now, the first quality that is described of these people that earn the title Ibadur Rahman is الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا. That they walk on the earth, those who walk on the earth, with humility, هَوْنًا, softly, acknowledging their weakness. You know, when we accomplish things, we feel a sense of kind of strength and power and empowerment. And those are the moments in life where we're supposed to acknowledge our humility. This is number one. And Hawnan also suggests that you don't demonstrate your strength in front of others. Allah talks about this on many occasions in the Quran. For example, lowering your wings before your parents. What does that mean? That means you're an adult, you have a career, you have money, you have your own car, you have a house, and your parents are retired, they're old. So obviously you're in a position of strength and they're in a position of weakness, but you need to not flap your wings too much. You need to chill out and act humbly in front of them. So the act of humility. You know, one time I met, recently I traveled, and there was a brother who picked us up from the airport, drove us around everywhere, and kind of just took care of everything. This guy was literally like a servant, driving us around all over the place, right? For food, for lectures, for this, for that, anything else I can do. Can I get you some water? Can I do this? Can I do that? Like, super humble brother. At the end of the trip, we find out the guy's worth like $700 million. I couldn't fathom, like, how does this work? Where do you get this kind of humility? I know people that make like $100,000 and think they own the world, right? They get into, you know, they topple, they'll go a little bit over six figures, and they're like, that's right, you know? And this guy, you know, so just the humility just shattered me. Like, how in the world can this be? And I was reminded, وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنَ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا. It's number one. They learn to walk on the earth with humility. Humility is also not just a demonstration of financial strength, it's also a demonstration, an undue demonstration of physical strength and intimidation. It can also be a demonstration of your ability to out-talk someone. Maybe you're a very aggressive, outgoing person, you like to make a lot of jokes, you can really put somebody in their place, especially in a public setting. You need to chill out and kind of hold back from that, don't do that. Because that's an expression of arrogance then, because you are overpowering someone with your tongue. You can overpower someone and put someone in their place with your mouth. You can, you know something about a field, an area, and you just want to stump somebody with your knowledge. Don't do that. You know, it's good for you that you know, but you don't have to like prove yourself at every juncture. You know. For example, a teacher. A teacher's job is not to prove to his students that he knows. A teacher's job is to try to teach. You know, and you don't have to go and tell everybody your credentials all the time. You don't have to do that. You just be yourself. Just be yourself and be humble before people. As a matter of fact, try to hide your capability in some cases if it means it'll just be a source of intimidation for others, you know? So now this is Haunan.